Environmental Science, Lesson 31A, Water Conservation at Different Levels. Today we are going to deal with Part 1. Hello learners, welcome to our Environmental Science Senior Secondary course of NIOS. When we started our journey of Environmental Science course, we had talked about origin and evolution of environments, its biotic and abiotic component, as well as natural resources, which includes living and non-living both. We have also discussed various issues related to degradation, over-exploitation and conservation of environment. Now we will discuss about role of individual as well as community to conserve water for future generations. So I am Dr. Padmaja Saxena, Assistant Professor, Dayal Singh College, University of Delhi. In this lesson, you will learn some important methods of conserving water and the role of individuals, community and government in conservation of water. So the objective of this program are: discuss the various methods to overcome water scarcity, concept of water use efficiency may be included. Second, explain watershed management and cite examples of individual actions towards preventing water scarcities, which will be the case study. What is the need for water conservation? Water is important substance for preserving life. In fact, scientists keep on studying for evidence of life on other planets in regard to the presence of water as a vital clue. We are rapidly depleting the global supply of fresh water, and this reality could potentially have dire consequences. So the need for its conservation. So methods of conservation of water are like recycling of water, reforestation, recharging of groundwater, water harvesting and reuse of waste water. So different methods of water conservation. India is a developing country with a vast territory, complex topography, varied climate and a large population. The precipitation and runoff in the country is unevenly distributed with regard to time of distribution of water during the year. According to Indian Meteorological Department, there are only 40 rainy days in India and hence a long dry period. India, being an agricultural country, its economic development is linked with agriculture, and water is the major limiting factor for agriculture. Growing population and consequent need for increase in food production, requiring increasing area of agricultural fields and irrigation, are resulting in overuse of water. Due to over-exploitation of water resources, it has become scarce in many parts of our country. Hence, conservation of water is of great importance to the economic, social, and cultural development in India. Conservation techniques. Monsoon, however, is erratic, and the duration and the amount of rainfall is highly variable in different parts of our country. Hence, surface runoff needs to be conserved. The techniques for conservation of surface water are: first is conservation by surface water storage. Construction of various water reservoirs have been one of the oldest measures of water conservation. The scope of storage varies from region to region depending on water availability and topographic condition. The environmental impact of such storage also needs to be examined for developing environmental friendly strategies. Second is conservation of rainwater. This technique is specially suitable for areas having rainfall of considerable intensity, spread over large part, that is in the Himalayan area, Northeast state and Andaman and Nicobar Islands. In areas where rainfall is scanty and for a short duration, this technique will induce surface runoff, which can then be stored. So this is rainwater storage, which can be used for irrigation purpose. Rainwater storage systems are a simple method of capturing rainwater traditionally from roofs for use as an alternative water supply source and to reduce consumption of scheme water. When installed and maintained in accordance with recommended guidelines, they can provide high quality source of water. Details have been already discussed in Chapter 30A. Groundwater conservation. There is more groundwater than surface water, which is less expensive and economic resource and available almost everywhere. Groundwater is sustainable and reliable source of water supply. It is relatively less vulnerable to pollution and free of pathogens. It needs little treatment before use. So this is how groundwater can be recharged, and this can be used by installing hand pumps. There is no conveyance losses in underground based water supplies. Groundwater has low vulnerability to drought and is the key to life in arid and semi-arid regions. Out of the total 4,000 billion cubic meters precipitation that occurs in India, about 45 million hectare meter percolates as groundwater flow. It is impossible to tap the entire groundwater resources. The groundwater potential is only 490 billion cubic meter. As we have limited groundwater available, it is very important that we use it economically and judiciously and conserve it to the maximum. Techniques of groundwater management and conservation. So first is artificial recharge. The water table declines quickly due to low and erratic rainfall. The only alternative is to replenish the groundwater by artificial means. Water is spread over ground to increase area and length of time to remain in contact with soil, which allows maximum possible opportunity for water to enter into the ground. Contour farming is an example of such harvesting technique involving water and moisture control at a very simple level. It often consists of row of rocks placed along the contour of steps. Runoff captured by these barriers also allow for retention of soil, thereby serving as erosion control measure on gentle slopes. Percolation tank method. Percolation tanks are constructed across the water course for artificial recharge. The studies conducted in Maharashtra indicates that on an average, area of influence of percolation of 1.2 km square, the average groundwater rise was of the order of 2.5 meter and the annual artificial recharge to groundwater from each tank was 1.5 hectare meter. Catchment area protection, which is also called as CAP. This is also called as watershed protection or management plans. These form conserve and protect the quality of water in a watershed. It helps in withholding run of water temporarily by a check bund constructed across the streams in hilly terrain to delay the runoff so that greater time is available for water to seep underground, as you can see in the picture on the right hand side. Such methods are in use in northeast states in hilly areas of tribal belts. This technique also helps in soil conservation. Afforestation in the catchment area is also adapted for water and soil conservation. The next is interbasin transfer of water. Areas in western and peninsular region have comparatively low water resources, cultivable land ratio. Northern and eastern regions, which are drained by Ganga and Brahmaputra, have substantial water resources. Diverting water from region with surplus water to water deficient region can be adopted. Ganga Kaveri link would enable to transfer vast quantities of Ganga basin flood water running out to sea to west and southwest India. The transfer of the surplus Ganga water would make up for the periodical shortage in Son, Narmada, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri rivers. Adoption of drip sprinkler irrigation. Drip irrigation is an efficient method of irrigation in which a limited area near the plant is irrigated by dripping water. It is a suitable method for water scarce areas. This method is particularly useful in row crops. About 80% water consumption can be reduced by this method, whereas the drip irrigation can reduce water consumption by 50 to 70%. So this is the use of sprinklers in lawns and big fields, and this is pot irrigation by online dripplers. Management of growing pattern of crops. The crop selection should be based on efficiency of the crop to utilize the water. Some of the plants suitable for water scarce areas are first plants with shorter growth periods like spinach, baby corn, radish, cucumber, beets, or high yielding plants that require no increase in water supply like asparagus, beans, broccoli and cabbage. Another category is plants with deep and well-trenched roots like the eggplant, beans, tomato and peppers. And lastly, plants which cannot tolerate surface irrigation like strawberry, alfalfa. Reducing evapotranspiration. Evapotranspiration losses can be reduced by reducing the evaporation from soil surface and transpiration from the plants. In arid zones, considerable amount of water is lost in evaporation from soil surface. This can be prevented by placing watertight moisture barriers or watertight mulches on the soil surface. So this is how evapotranspiration occurs, which includes transpiration and evaporation. Non-porous materials like paper, asphalt, plastic foils or metal foils can also be used for preventing evaporation losses. Transpiration losses can be reduced by reducing air movements over a crop by putting wind breaks and evolving such types of crops which possess xerophytic adaptations. The method that reduce evaporation from water bodies are installing wind breaks, reducing energy available for evaporation, constructing artificial aquifers, minimizing exposed surface through reservoir regulation, reducing ratio of area to volume of water bodies, locating reservoirs at higher altitudes, and applying monomolecular forms. Recycling of water. The waste water from industrial or domestic sources can be used after proper treatment for irrigation, recharging groundwater, and even for industrial or municipal use. If agricultural lands are available close to cities, municipal waste water can be easily used for irrigation. Conservation of water in domestic use. There is a large scope of conserving water at household level. A general awareness among the people about the importance of water and its availability and need for conservation can help in minimizing wastage to a large extent. Some of the ways for improving the efficiency of water use at household level can be like reduced wastage or leaking of pipes, closing of taps when not in use, use of low flush toilets, reducing the amount of water used each time the lavatory is flushed, use of bowls to wash vegetables, dishes instead of running tap, greater use of recycled water instead of using potable or treated water, and use washing machine or dishwasher when it is fully loaded. Reduce the loss of water. There are numerous methods to reduce losses due to evaporation and to improve soil moisture. Mulching, that is the application of organic or inorganic materials such as plant debris, compost, wood chips or straw, etc., which slows down the surface runoff, improves soil moisture, reduces evaporation losses and improves soil fertility. Fields should not be left bare for long periods of time. Soil should be covered by crops that slow down runoff and minimize evaporation losses. Cover crops protect soil, allow water to penetrate the soil more easily, which improves its water holding capacity. Generally, cover crops are selected based on season and agroclimatic condition. In India, most frequently used cover crops are lentils, field peas, barsim, cowpea, soybean, etc. It helps in less crop weed competition. Plowing helps increase water absorption and reduces evaporation, erosion and compaction. Shelter belt of trees and bushes along the edges of agricultural fields slow down the wind speed and reduce evaporation and erosion. Planting of trees, grasses and bushes breaks the force of rain and helps rainwater penetrate the soil. Contour farming, as you have seen in the diagram on the right side, the figure on the right side, contour farming is adopted in hilly areas and in lowland areas for paddy fields for conserving soil and water. Salt resistant varieties of crops have been also developed recently because these grow in saline areas. Overall agricultural productivity is increased without making additional demands on fresh water sources. Thus, this is a good water conservation strategy. Desalination technologies such as distillation, electrodialysis and reverse osmosis can also be adopted. Reuse of wastewater. Wastewater is a resource rather than a waste since it contains appreciable amount of nitrogen, phosphorus and potash. Stabilization ponds can be used for fish or aquaculture. The effluent can also be used for cultivation of for short-term and long-term ornamental, commercial and fodder crops. Benefits of reuse. Reuse of treated wastewater has the following benefits. Make up for the shortage of water supply. It reduces demand on good quality water, reduces the wastewater discharge, thus reducing water pollution, results in cost reduction, agricultural use through irrigation of crops. Industrial cooling, especially in large industrial enterprises, reuse in municipal public areas such as watering lawns, parks, playgrounds, flushing toilets in hotels and residential districts, reuse of the treated wastewater for urban landscape purposes. Treated wastewater can also be used for groundwater recharging. Untreated water. Water or grey water can also be reused for various purposes. Now, what is grey water? Grey water is defined as untreated household wastewater which has not come into contact with toilet waste. It can originate from the shower, bath, bathroom, wash basin, clothes, washing machine and laundry troughs. So this is how we can use the water at household level. Now, watershed management. Watershed management is a technique for conservation of water and soil in a watershed. This is the region from which surface water draws into a river, lake, wetland, or other body of water. Forests and their associated soils and litter layers are excellent filters as well as sponges, and water that passes through this system is relatively pure. Various kinds of forest disturbances can speed up the movement of water from the system and in effect reduce the filtering action. In mountainous regions, the forests play a prominent role in prevention of soil erosion. Erosion can be prevented by the maintenance of continual cover. Ideally, this is achieved by single stem harvesting. Only one tree is felled at any one point, and the small gap so created is soon sealed by the outward growth of its neighbors. Deforested land sheds water swiftly, causing sudden rise in the river levels. Over a large river system, such as that of Ganga and the Yamuna, forests are a definite advantage since they lessen the risk of floods. They also provide conditions for favorable to fishing and navigation than does unforested land. All natural streams containing varying amounts of dissolved and suspended matter, water from forested areas are low in foreign substances and are relatively high in oxygen and low in unwanted chemicals. The air above a forest, as contrasted with grassland, remains relatively cool and humid on hot days, so that showers are more frequent. Many areas in India used to get significant rainfall when they were forested and are now facing severe drought due to denudation. Example are the deserts of Rajasthan. The belief that forests increase rainfall has not been substantiated by scientific inquiry. Local effects can, however, prove substantial, particularly in semi-arid regions where every millimeter of rain counts. The air above a forest, as contrasted with grassland, remains relatively cool and humid on hot days, so that showers are more frequent. So this is all we have done about the methods, how we can conserve water at different levels. So before we wrap up, we would like to recap the main points. That is what we have learnt in this chapter, that water is a scarce resource. It needs to be conserved through many methods. Efficient use of water at domestic and agricultural level may save water significantly. Better irrigation techniques are very important in water conservation. Recycling of wastewater is very important in water conservation. Watershed is an area through which water body gets its water. Protection of forest and vegetation helps conservation of water in watershed. Forest soil litter is a good filter media for impurities of water. So this is all about the water conservation at different level. We will come again to meet you with a new program of environmental science. Thank you.